Now, I am a self-professed sort of astronomy geek, okay? Nothing wrong with being a geek, by the way. But with us, we have RIT's Brian Koberlein, an astronomer, here to tell us all about this phenomenon, what it means, and how we can actually see it with RIT's help.
Well, this is an interesting one. It is a supermoon, a harvest moon, and the lunar eclipse.
Ooh, wow. So you've got this trifecta.
All of these things trifecta, yeah.
So for people who don't know what the lunar eclipse is, tell us.
Well, a lunar eclipse occurs when the Earth is between the sun and the moon. Mm-hmm. And so the shadow of the Earth casts on the moon.
Okay. And so that causes the moon, as I recall, to have a very unique appearance, almost like a blood red or copperish hue.
Right? Yeah. Sometimes they'll call it a blood moon. Mm-hmm. It's a deep red, dark red color, and the reason is because the Earth has completely blocked the sun, but because of Earth's atmosphere, it refracts the rays like sunset. So basically what you're getting is the light of a deep sunset all around the Earth hitting the moon.
Now, we are in for you have to have a full moon, right?
You always have to have a full moon to have a lunar eclipse.
Okay,
yes.
And how easy is it to see without a telescope?
You can
just look up and see it.
Just look up and see it. If you have a clear view of the moon, then you'll be able to see it. It's over the course of about 3 hours.
So talk about this event coming up on Sunday night. RIT is inviting the public to come witness this with them, with the experts. This is what I love. You go down to John Street?
Yeah, it's off of John Street. You go to the RIT Observatory, and Professor Michael Richmond is going to be hosting this. It's open to the public. And come out between 8 and midnight, and you can see the moon. You get a clear view of it. And you can also ask questions of experts there.
That's awesome. I mean, if I know it's a little late, obviously, maybe too late for some kids, maybe all kids, but the great thing, huh?
It's worth getting
It's worth it, though. Come on. But the thing is, though, that, you know, people get to ask the experts about what's actually happening. How often do these lunar eclipses happen?
Well, they happen twice a year, but it depends on whether or not they're easy to see.
Okay, because sometimes they're not. What makes them not easy to see?
Well, sometimes the moon will be, the Earth will be a little bit higher or lower, so you get a partial lunar eclipse. Sometimes it happens to happen, you know, when the moon is not in our area, but it's in some other part of the world, and so we can't see it.
Right.
You know, but now it's very good because it's Sunday evening, so it's a perfect spot for us this time.
Yeah, and you mentioned, though, again, it's a harvest moon, which means what?
It's the full moon closest to the fall equinox.
Okay, and then it's also, what else?
It's a supermoon, is
super
what some people are calling it.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So the Earth's the moon's orbit around the Earth is not a perfect circle.
Right.
And so
an oval?
It's a little bit of an oval. It's an ellipse.
Right.
And so there's a period in its orbit when it's a little bit closer than its average distance to the Earth. And so the moon is slightly bigger, slightly brighter.
These events have fascinated people for eons, haven't they?
Oh, yeah.
There have been, I can only imagine that people, you know, ancient peoples probably saw this and thought, it was a harbinger of something to come, good or bad.
Mm-hmm.
But this was, it's been happening since time eternal, and we're still fascinated by them.
We're still fascinated by them.
Yeah. We know they're going to happen, but there's still, there's an ooh and ah factor, isn't
Absolutely.
There?
Absolutely. Yeah, it's a wonderful thing to see. And the nice thing about a lunar eclipse is that it's much easier to see than a solar eclipse.
Right.
Solar eclipses are rare, but lunar eclipses, when you have the chance, it's very easy to see if it's in your area.
I love it. Okay, so this event that's happening on Sunday night, or should say this gathering on Sunday night at RIT is free.
Yes.
Okay. Where is the observatory again?
It's off of John Street.
Okay.
If you know where John Street is, then you'll find it. You'll see it. It looks like a house, but it's next to the observatory.
I know exactly what you're talking about. I've seen it in the past. If you want to know more about it, then go to rit.edu/cos/observatory if you want to know exactly where they're going to be. It is free, and again, looking up to see the moon is free too, right? I mean, you don't need anything really. You don't need a telescope. You can just see it. That's awesome. How exciting. And then again, 2017 is the lunar eclipse.
The solar eclipse.
Oh, the solar eclipse.
Yeah,
excuse me.
It's going to go across the United States, so be prepared for that.
A lot of celestial big-time happenings, right? And that's a totally scientific
total
word.
Solar eclipse.
Brian, you would totally use those, that way that I described it. It was just scientifically
appropriate.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That's why we have you here, Brian. Thank you so much, Brian Koberlein.
Thank you.